buddy.
It's me again.
Aren't you excited?
Yeah.
Me too. Because today we're going to talk about painting with some new paints I got. These Lukas Berlin water soluble oil paints. That's some crazy, weird, messed up stuff right there. How can it be oil paint if it's water soluble? I don't know. Water mixable oil color, or if you want to read it, Vossen Mission Baden Newton, whatever that is. Okay, so these are pretty nifty. They are made in England for a German company. Go figure. They weren't ridiculously expensive, but they're not cheap. From Jerry's, I got them on sale, of course, because I am ridiculously cheap. You can see the colors you get. You get burnt umber, yellow ochre, and I'm trying to see it in English. Oh, viridian, and ultramarine blue, cerulean blue, alizarin crimson, alizarin or whatever crimson. It's just red. Vermilion, cadmium yellow, primary yellow, and of course, titanium white. The thing I like about this set is there's no black in it, which, you know me, I don't use black, like almost never, so that's not a problem, and I would much rather have the extra colors. So it's really not a bad little set. And what we're gonna use today is this, and I have a little 8x10 basic cheap canvas. Your basic water, basic brushes. You got a 2-inch flat. You got like a, I think it's a 1-inch or 3/4 flat. You got a number 8 round. You got a number 1 liner for detail. And then this is like a 1/2-inch flat. Okay, or shader. These are the basic brushes I use all the time. Actually, these are the basic brushes I use in my paint along classes if you've ever been to them. This is what you get. Yeah, they're all kind of beat looking like that too, so. But they work. I do clean them. I do take care of them. But they're kind of beat. So, and this is the cheesy little palette I use. I like this one because it's easier to hold. Of course, I hold it this way. But they're kind of nice and you can clean them. One little tip, if you're trying to clean this after you've used it a while, the paint comes off pretty easily when it's wet, but if it dries on there and you're having a hard time, use a scrubber, like a stainless steel or copper scrubber, and it will take everything off. It just takes a little bit of elbow grease, but it will come right off. So that's what I always use, because you see how scraped up this is. I've had it for a while. So to get ready for this painting, we're going to do sketches. I already did sketches, and I decided I'm going to do a little octopus. Okay. Here's some octopus pictures I found online that I kind of liked. Okay. And then these are the sketches that I did. And here's a cutesy one. Here's one that has more movement. And then this one I call creepy, but I like it. It's the most interesting of the lot. This one, though, might be kind of hard to do on such a little canvas. So what I might end up doing, I haven't totally decided yet, is to do the cutesy or maybe a combination thereof. I like the angle of this one better than I do this one, but I think this one will be easier for most people to paint. So I'm looking for something that you guys can paint and not tear your hair out doing it, and you know, and curse and call me names at the end of the day. Of course, people do that anyway, but anywho. So, we're going to try out these nifty cool paints. First, we're gonna do our background, of course. You know me, we gotta start from the back and work to the front. So, first thing I'm gonna do is try out this Viridian, which is kind of a teal color. If you don't have it, you can mix it with blue and green. It's not hard. And I'm gonna take some shades of blue. I have some music going on today, so if you don't like it, oh well. And it's non-copyright, royalty-free, so hopefully YouTube won't go, you can't do that! Because I'm not trying to infringe on anybody. So I took a little bit of each of the blues I have here. If you see, there's, this is Viridian, Ultramarine, and Cerulean. I'm going to take our little, this one, this is like 1 inch flat here. I get it wet. I'm going to soften it up. Okay. And what I'm going to do is take some of the green, some of this. I guess the difference between acrylic and this water-soluble oil is that they use the same pigments like they use in oil, except it's a water-based paint. So I'll let you know if I think it's any different than acrylic or not. I will tell you one thing right now. The pigments seem a little more intense. So I'm going to use quite a bit of water on this to do it kind of like a wash. And I'm going to make one corner darker than the other because, of course, our light is going to be coming from one direction. And you can work in both ways. Kind of mix it up. There, I like this Viridian. This is kind of cool. So we're gonna come in. Ooh, ah. Look at that. And don't forget to paint the edges, kitties. So we're gonna do this. Pick this up. My picture's gonna fall, so don't freak out. It's got some nice pigment to it, I'll tell you that. It's a richer color, I guess you could say. More like oil. Disadvantage to oil is not very portable. If you're going to go out and paint outside like I do, I'll go to events and paint like I do. It's not going to work really well because it's not that easy to carry turpentine and all this stuff around with you. But now, water, way easier. And you can drink it even better. So what we're going to do is just work through this little background here. Because this critter's under the sea. He's also a sea critter, as I like to call him. Sea critter! That's more fun to say. Okay. So feel free to just lightly brush like this. Look at that. It's got some nice color to it. Take some of the cerulean blue and throw that in here. Ooh. It's interesting. Back on there. I'll switch hands. When I do backgrounds, it's easy to switch hands. It's not like a lot of detail. If I don't need a break. And then I'm going to take some more of that Viridian, which I kind of like. This paint has a weird smell to it, I'll tell you that. Is it me, or is it... No, it has a funky smell to it. It's kind of weird. Most paints don't. They smell plasticky, but not this one. This one smells kind of more like, you know, oil paints have a funky smell to them. Except I'm using water, go figure. It's mutant paint, okay? It's water, it doesn't matter. Okay? And I'm going to make this corner up here darker, like this, because it's just something I want to do. Come back over like this. You think about it, this is a sea critter. He's going to be under the water. It's not incredibly deep water. If it were incredibly deep, you probably wouldn't be there. Octopus will go, they will go deep, but octopus are one of the most intelligent of whatchamacuses, invertebrates. Invertebrates, that just means they don't have a backbone. Or a mollusk or whatever. I know people go, nah, 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 whatever. I know that they're smart, let's just put it that way. If you've ever had one in a tank, they will figure out how to escape. You have to actually tape and cover all the openings because they're going to run away. Unless they have a happy place to stay in their tank, like flower pots. Things they can climb inside of and feel safe. And you know they have a beak inside of them and where their mouth is, and that's how they break things open to eat them. There we go. Okay. Whoa, well, we have this pretty little colored background here. Take some more of that ultramarine blue when I do this. Dab, dab, dab. Add some more water, some more ultramarine blue. And dab it like this. There we go. Just enough water to let it run a little bit. And another thing you can do to get some weird different is take a paper towel, highly expensive, sought after, not so much now, but still, get it wet just a little bit and just kind of do this. I'm just going to lightly touch it, kind of do this number, especially in the areas where you want it to be lighter, like over in this corner, I want it to be lighter. This. There. And then, you know, if you don't like it or if you want to add more here or there, you can. Let's do this. So just play with it a little bit till you get it to where you like it. And put this up here and some more of this meridian stuff. Darken up that corner a bit. You do it at the top and it's on a little, this is a little, not a table easel, it's a little drawing box that I use that has storage inside of it to keep pens and stuff. You can even put brushes in there, whatever. They're not that expensive. You can find them online all over the place, eBay. Or all the online places, art supply. They're kind of nice. There we go. So just, you know, look at your background. I'm not going to spend tons of time on it. Just see what you think it should look like. It's your painting, not mine, yours. I'm going to darken up this bottom corner over here a little bit too. Kind of like you're going, this is deeper, this is more shallow. So as it's deeper, it's going to be darker because it's farther away. And there's less light. Duh. Okay. There. Take this. And I'm mixing the viridian with some of this ultramarine. I pretty much used it up. And I'm going to do it this way. There we go. And feel, I just kind of move it like this. And if you do that, it gives your painting automatically a little bit of movement. You know, it's like a Cezanne trick, okay? Like this, okay? Because water does what? It's constantly moving. Even when there's no wind blowing, you have currents, especially in the ocean. There. So now you have this kind of neat background where it's darker back here, it's lighter here. This is where we're going to be doing our octopus. And he's going to be kind of going into this. If you look, like I said, there's these different things for reference. Those are for reference. I don't copy them. I don't draw it out first on the canvas. I don't use a ruler. I don't say you have to do. There's too many rules, people. We don't need all these rules. We just need to paint. Just do what you want to do. If you like it, that's what counts. And even if you don't, somebody else will. I guarantee it. Just when you do something, and I can't tell you how many times, people, I don't really like it. I'm like, eh. And I've been that close to painting over it, and somebody else loves it. It's like, really? Okay then. You can have it. So, like I said, these are the little sketches I did. I didn't spend a lot of time on these. I spent maybe 10 minutes on everything. So, don't waste a lot of time. Just do your dimensions. If it's a horizontal canvas, then draw a horizontal box. Don't do a square if your canvas is not square. This is not square. This is an 8x10 canvas. So, boom. Okay? So now we got to figure out which one we're going to do. And I still haven't decided yet. Surprise. All right, we're back. I let my paint dry. This stuff dries pretty fast, by the way, just like acrylic. So it has all the advantages of acrylic so far. It's a Lukas Berlin water soluble oil paint. It has the only thing I can say about it has a kind of a funky smell to it. Not bad, but just kind of goofy, funky, like, but as far as how you use it and everything, it's just like acrylic, but it's more intense in its color than some acrylic, which is kind of nice. Kind of like painting with ink, but not quite. So now we're gonna do our fabulous little fun octopus. Now what color should we do our octopus? You know, octopus come in all different colors. They can change colors. Most of them are kind of yellowish reddish like this. There's a blue ring octopus that will kill you in 15 minutes. I decided not to paint that one just cause, you know. But I'm thinking I kind of like a pinkish purple color would stand out good against this background and be kind of neat looking. So, I'm looking at this just for reference once again, and we're going to look and see, what would work. So, I think we're going to, I have all the colors in here, by the way. Here's your burnt sienna, your umbers, your yellows, your reds, and then your blues and greens, and I have white over here. We're going to start out with our round. Put some water on it. I think I'm going to take this El Arisian Crimson, which is almost purplish. Maybe put a little red with it. Maybe a tad of white here, just to lighten it up a bit. All I did was clean this part of the canvas, palette off. I didn't want the blue in there. And like I said, here's my happy sketches. Which one am I going to do? Nobody knows, huh? The suspense is killing you, I know. I can barely stand it myself. I don't know. You know what it is. When I paint, I just decide, okay, I'm going to do this. It's just like, you know, like old Bob Ross says, you know? Excuse me. It's like you have the control, you make the decisions. It's one of the few things you can do in life where, yeah, you do have all that control. Most of the time somebody's griping at you or says they want this, blah, 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 blah. So, how are we going to do this? Just figure it out, okay? I want him coming off the canvas. I like these long,
You need a lot of water for this, and more paint. He's got these long tentacles that kind of wrap around like this. Okay. And he's going to kind of come up, and his head kind of comes up like this. And he's going to go off. And this canvas has not been gessoed. If you gesso your canvas, it will be smoother and easier to paint. But like most of the time, I just don't have a lot of time. So I have tendency just to paint on the old canvas. I do admit that gessoing is nicer to paint on. So it's up to you. And he's going to have this little eye. See, what I'm looking at is kind of like this one here. He's got this kind of little eye that's going to stick out like this. There we go. Yeah. Just kind of work the paint around. You don't want too much water because it'll run, but you want enough water so that you can move the paint around. And he's going to come back down here like this, like that. And this canvas isn't 100% dry, so that's kind of good in some ways, because the blue kind of comes in there. And where his eye is going to be, which is going to be somewhere in this neighborhood, I'm not going to paint over that area right now. I'm going to leave it. But you, if you do, it's not the end of the world. Don't cry or freak out. I'm going to tape this up here. You know, I'm all high tech here. Nothing but high tech. Okay. Lost my brush. Oh, there it is. You would think, how could I lose a brush in this tiny space? Special that way. Okay, take this. We got these two shades of red and a little bit of white, and he's going to come right around the corner like this, right off the canvas. And you can go back and do that after, but I kind of like to do it at the same time, because then your paint is very consistent. That's the only problem with going back and doing it later, is sometimes it's hard to get the exact same color of paint and consistency. Okay. So I'm using a lot of water, so it's kind of almost like a wash, this paint. There's a little more water in there than I like. So, the thing about these tentacles is they are going to just curl around like this. And do a light touch when you do this, people. Don't be a hammer hand, okay? Make it easier on yourself. There we go. There. The mantle. See? Things you learn. Different parts of the octopus. And then right here, this little part right there, that's where the water goes. They swim backwards, and yes, you have to make the noise. So, if you don't put that in there, you can do that after. It makes it hard for the little guy to swim. And that's why they go backwards. You can't really go forward unless they crawl and grab stuff. So, we're going to do the happy little legs here. And yes, everyone knows how many legs they have, right? It's an octopus. Not a centipus. Okay. Octo means what? Eight. That's right. Okay. So you don't have to put all eight legs in here. This is your painting. He can do whatever. He can come down and his little... They can do this. You just let your little brush go. Okay. Add some more white to it. Yeah. You see, it's darker over here, right? So in order for it to stand out a little more, we're going to throw a little more white in it. There we go. And let's throw a little ultramarine blue in there. And it's going to be a little purpley.
Look at that.
Ooh, oh. And let's do this. Let's do this one's going to curl around like this. Boom. And let's make one that kind of comes around like this. It goes whoop, just right off like that. That's the nice thing about having all these legs, right? One, two, three, four. I still got four to play with. What the heck? Let's do some white. Now look at this neat purpley color. Okay. And he's got these other ones that kind of come down from here. You see his little body kind of comes down with this. Because right now he's looking like a squid because he's pretty narrow. There we go. And octopus are actually pretty good to eat if you're eating them. It's horrible if you don't even think about eating them. But squid are better, I think. And this comes down and we're going to have it go right off and then it's going to come back right here. See? Three. Okay. Just don't lose track of where your legs are going. There we go. And then let's do one here. And this one can come around like this. And you're saying, but this one's going to cover it up. It's okay. You can go back and make it stand out more later. It is possible. Yeah, let's throw some blue in there. Some more white. This paint is intense. The colors are pretty... So you can go back over it, fill in where it needs it. Okay. This is they're wider, going to be wider at the top where they come off the body, and then they're going to narrow as they get to the end. You see, like this one can even do this. It's more interesting than there. He's got some crazy legs going on, see? Because they're just all... Wah! And I'm thinking I'm going to do one like right in here. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five, six. I still have two legs to play with. Now, if you want to make one with nine legs and hope nobody notices, you know, go for it. But I'm going to do this. There. See, this is more red. You can go red. You can go purple if you want to make him blue. You want to make him hot pink? You just go. I'm not going to stop you. There. Just hoping to come down here. Okay.
And the thing about octopuses is they can stretch their legs out a lot. So if you say, well, it's too long, or it's too this, it's too that. Really? Have you ever watched one? These particular pictures up here, you see they're squished in, they're fat, they're thicker. But if you look at this one, you see how long they can get. They can really stretch out, so. And it's just interesting to make them all over the place, because it's just more interesting. It breaks up your canvas. It's not so boring to look at. And then you've got that background in there with all that color, so you're going to make it like against that color. And you could go lighter on that background if you wanted to. That's your painting once again. I'm going to take my little brush here, my liner, some of this nice bright red, maybe take some of this yellow and brighten it up a bit, some of this other yellow. Put it in here. I think I need more white. These colors are so intense compared to a standard acrylic that I can see where you need a little more white to bring the white, you know what I mean? There, you can see. There we go. So I'm going to come in here and just kind of because you know on their tentacles they have the underside where all the little suction cups are. And that's going to curve around like this. And those will add later. See, I want to make this a little wider. Just do that. And you could even do some wacky colors in there if you wanted, you know? Do like spots and stuff on there if you want, which I might do. So this one here, I wanted to make it wider. So just come in here and do this. And, oh, let's just grab this and make it go off the edge and come back like this. What? Let's see. You're going to paint the whole canvas and not this. Oh, I get to the edge and it's gone. Whatever. That to me is like, I guess maybe because I'm cheap. I like to use everything. This is going to come down like this. A little hook on the end. Okay. And then this one. I'm going to smooth out. There. I'm going to make this wider right here. It goes back onto his body because it is. Just like this. See. And by adding these different colors, it gives it more dimension, right? Like that. So you're going to do this all over the canvas. All the legs. And you could do it faster if you used a bigger brush. but I want to make sure I get the ends just right. Okay, so now you're looking at this leg right here. You got to decide, is that leg in front of that leg, or is that leg in front of this leg? Because the way you paint it will make a difference on where it's at. I think I'm going to make it in front of it, because it's up here. This to me looks like it's, so we're going to go like this. So, now we're going to go put some more blue in here. Make it more purpley. Purpley. Take that ultramarine blue and add it in there and it's more purple. Yeah, I may just take a bigger brush. You shouldn't want to sit here for 3 hours watching me paint tentacles on an octopus. Probably falling asleep already, I know. They're happy trees. Happy trees. This guy. I'm going to make him darker back there. So we can take some of this blue, some of this red. Ooh. Now it's kind of a dark purpley color. Look at that. See? There we go. That one kind of goes in there like that. This one's going to kind of come in here like this. See? This one's going to come in here like that. And they have these ridges that run up like this, like where his eye is. So like I said, before you draw something, take some, you can't see it, you can kind of see it here better. There's ridges that run above their eyes, like eyebrows, right here. See, so take some of the lighter color, or you can take some white, throw it in there, so you can see that. Where that ridge is. See where the dots, you can do dots. See? Ooh, ah. We're going to put dots on them when we're done. I'm just trying to make some eyebrows to show you. I'm going to take some of this red. Yeah. There's this red that comes through here. Oh, and his little, I can't remember the name of it. Take some red and this blue. And you could even take a little bit of the burnt sienna and throw it in there. And that's going to be right around here. Like this. See? Like that. You can see it better on this one. See it here? More. And then we're going to take some more of this blue and mix it in there. Take advantage of that dark paint we have on the areas where the light isn't hitting as much, like right here. And then maybe right in here. We'll take some of this red and throw it in there. There we go. He could be a happy octopus, a creepy octopus, an angry octopus. You decide. Okay? You can even see a line that runs right around here. If you want to get really ticky-tack, you can do that. It's up to you. I'm going to take a little brush again and go in here. Thank you. areas where you're painting, your background is lighter, you may want to accentuate that tentacle against it by doing some dark on it, like this. Same thing in here. Here we go. And where it's underneath, go darker. There. Okay. Now it really starts to look like an octopus. I still have to do some work on this tentacle here. But he's getting pretty close to the fun part where we get to add all the dots and make him really look like an octopus. You know, and it's up to you how much time you want to spend on him. You can spend a lot less time and do a lot less detail. That's your decision. So I'm just going to touch up these rough spots here. So once again, where is this going? Remember we did this earlier and we're like, but it's overlapping, I don't know. Let's take some of that white. And we're going to add it and make that's like this kind of lavender color. Look at this. All of a sudden, it's over this, see? Throw some red in there. There we go. You can add more white. The light's hitting it more. Yeah. Maybe there it is. That looks more interesting. See? Like a little curly cue. Other areas you're painting where there's more light, you can use it, or if you don't. Yeah, just like a little highlight. Boom. So let's fix that back one there because he's fading away into nothingness. Of course, if you like that fading away into nothingness, eat it. I'm going to go darker because that's in the background. It's like creating your own little paint by number. Except the numbers are in your head. Okay? Or in my head. There we go. See? Since that tentacle is in the back, it's darker, right? It went off the canvas again, so we have to pick up our canvas and then do that. And you know, I get more people that when they look at my painting, they go, wow, I really like that. It's so simple. See, it's running. See how it's running? Oh no, I've ruined it. That's where your friend, the paper towel, comes in. Just dab it. Dab it. There. It's not the end of the world. I'll show you how to fix it. There we go. So, here we go. So what we're doing, see, I'm trying to, forget it, put it over here so you can see it. I'm fixing this, where it started to run, and that's okay. Because then what we're gonna do is take some of the pink, which is okay, it's white, with some red, and we're going to go over this like this. There we go. Maybe throw a little more of this red in here. There we go. tentacle's basically done. The ones, this is in the back behind him, so it's darker. The ones that are up front are lighter. And if you do that, and then the ends may be lighter, so they look like they're coming out more, it'll give him more dimension than if he's just all one color. I mean, if you want to go for the all one color look, go for it, but I'm not doing that today, so. And his eyes are black. You know me in black. We'll do the eye a little later. Let's go in and start doing some of the fun stuff. We're going to do some of these highlights, which I'm going to need some more white again. Because this paint, man, it is intense. Okay? So we're going to take some white, and we're going to take some of this yellow. Yeah, and you're going to go, it looks like mud. Well, it kind of does. And then this other yellow over here. You want a nice kind of warmish color here. There. So, remember the eyebrows? Just take the tip of your brush. Kind of do this. And this is where they have all these neat spots on them. Kind of do this. Yeah. If you look at this, they have like polka dots on them. Like this. Yeah, they do. And see, this dude has a lot of white up in his eye area. By using the color all over your canvas in different areas. See? So it's not so boring. Even back here on this dark leg, just don't use as much. You know? You want to keep it kind of dark. Don't forget when he goes off the canvas. Like that. See? Okay. Can you see it? Okay. Little vent, I can't remember the name of it, I should have looked it up so I could tell you, but we're going to do a little of this with a little brush, see, and it comes around, round it off a bit, right here, and if you use the paint thinner, there's that little line. Those off ends. Now his eye, they don't have a white to their eyes. They have a funky pupil. Okay. But what we're going to do is paint that area where the eye goes. See? Eyes are really important. A lot of times I leave them for the last, because even if you've painted for years and years, and you think you're like Rembrandt, you're like the best artist that ever lived, it takes a while to get used to each canvas and the paint, and this is a paint I've never used before, so. I like to just kind of do the other areas and then the areas where I think are the most important, which is the eye, I'm going to leave till the end, or towards the end, because I have a better feeling for the paint. So the eye is going to be right in this area. So it's going to have to dry a little bit on that, where that eye is. But we can continue to do this other sections. And then I'm going to take just white, and I've already got enough paint on this brush.
And we're going to do some of these canopies, the suction cups, the little suckers. And a little trick is don't make them go all the way across in a straight line, because their tentacles are always, they move around a lot. So they kind of curl around and go off. Like, see, that's the back of it. This is underneath because he's going beep. So if you really want to make them look like that, just do some of it. Okay. Like that. And see, it'll look like it. People know what it is. He's got this one kind of flipped. And then it kind of comes down. And since this stuff is pretty intense, and there's going to be some down here. Not a whole lot's going to be hanging out right here. And they're going to be bigger as they get towards them. Up in this area, they're smaller on the ends. So just take some time to do it, and it does take some time. Right here. Just like little white spots, and you can throw some other paint. I'm gonna throw some more yellow in there. It's a good contrast against that background. See, look at that. And then up in here. They can even come off the edge like this. See, this one kind of comes off the edge. Because if you look right in here, you can see how they do that. They're like, wait. So I said I use photos for reference to make sure I get this stuff right. And sometimes you forget. You don't look at octopuses every day unless you have one in a fish tank in your living room, which I've done that before, but you may not. Most people don't. So feel free to use photographs for reference, and don't feel like you're riddled with guilt. I'm not copying the photograph, though. That would be there. See? This makes it more interesting to add some of these dots. And then remember this one here that was in front? It's really going to look like it's in front of the windows. So you can take this really light color. And then stop and sit back and look at it. Go, okay.
sometimes it's good to get up and walk away and come back and look at it too, because you get so tuned into one little area. It's like, oh, I need to fix this, or I need to fix that. Take some of this white mixture I have going on here, throw some more red in it. I'm gonna make some of these kind of stick out a little more right here. So not just one big flat there. Somewhere right here. There we go. Now, his eye should be dry enough. I'm gonna kind of come up here like this, where the eye should be. Now we're gonna take this brown and some of the ultramarine blue. And you'd want it fairly thick. Clean out the white off your brush. Clean the white off your brush. Take this and mix it. Mix this a really nice dark color. And his eyes are going to be right in here. See? Take some of the blue. There. And I'm not done with that eye. Now, since we have this nice dark blue on here, you can kind of come in here in some of these areas and throw some, like I said, balance it out. Some of these areas that I know are really dark. He's getting there. Stay. Let's do this. I'm gonna screw this up over here. It's not even. I don't like it. Let's fix it. There we go. Okay, that's better. And then this one, I was like, you know what? Let's make this a little darker in here. Want this to stand out more. It's getting a little darker behind it. Like this. See? Then it's like, same with this. There. You know, get out of the habit of making it a straight, one big, huge line. Your eye will fill it in anyway. If you get into the habit of breaking that line out more, you'll find out that it's more interesting to look at. Let's do some red around this eye. I need more red. Red, red, red. You might ask why you're putting that around the eye as well. Because I want you to look at his eye a little more. Put a little more intense bright color to kind of lead up to it. And people are going to look at it more. You're naturally going to look at it more. And then we're going to take some of that white and some of that yellow. But if your paint isn't 100% dry when you're doing this, and it starts to muddy up, just go do something else in the painting and come back and do it. It'll dry. This stuff dries pretty fast, though. Most acrylic does. And if you're outside painting, it dries really, really fast, especially if you live where it's like hot all the time. If you live in the Great White North where it's freezing cold, you can always use a hairdryer or put it under a light, a lamp. I've done that before. Now we have an octopus. Now let's get some stuff in the background. Because why is he swimming around like this? Just feels like it. He's going from spot A to spot B. Well, yeah. But maybe there's some like happy fish or something in the background he wants to eat. A big octopus will eat fish.
You're just like, what?
No, they do. And you already have this nice blue and this purple. Just kind of mix it all up. And just do this little fish shape, see? And they're dark. They're swimming away. They're just like, I am out of here. I don't want anything to do with this guy. He's a kraken. I want him gone. So you take some of these dark colors and just kind of do these little fish shapes back here. It gives you the impression that there's fish swimming away. Far, far away. Run away. There we go. Okay? Because this little guy right here, this is what he's going to do, is try and grab in one of these dudes. And then maybe down here, there's some seaweed or coral. But you're not going to see all of it. You're just going to see shapes. So you can kind of do this. And if you want to look at pictures of coral, if you've never seen it, you can do that. See how it kind of grows on the bottom. Or it could just be rocks. Or maybe some seaweed. You know? Okay? Wow. I'm going to paint this darker. That's down on the bottom. It's like a little ledge he's coming out of there, okay? Then you take your little brush, that little liner brush, take some of this blue and this viridian, this wonderful blue and this dark color you had, which you used for his eyeball. Kind of do this. And there's like little beady fish down here. Because they hang out around coral. That's how they stay safe. When the big octopus comes around, they hide in it. Right? There we go, see? There they are, they're going. They're like little fish going, help! Run away! The thing about the ocean is it's just not one critter living in it. There's a whole bunch of them. Sometimes you can't always see them. If you really look. And the school of fish looks just like a bunch of little shapes. See? Boom! That's more interesting. I think it needs a little more red, just to brighten it up. So I'm going to take this vermilion, because I wanted a brighter red, slap some of that right out of the tube, boom. I'm going to clean this brush off. I'm going to take some of this vermilion. I'm going to kind of do this number.
to give it a little more zip. You know? So that he's a little more. You can even throw some yellow in there. Look at that here. See? It's almost orange. Which is pretty intense. So you can put it on those tentacles you want just to stand out a little more. Make it a little more fun. On all over the place. Here we go. Get around this eye here. Like eyeliner. It's into fashion. It's fashion. Or she. Could be she. See? Because the red stands out good against this background. Now it's not so boring. Change colors really fast. What do they call it? Chromatophores or something like that. They're a color changing cell in them. That's how they camouflage. It's also how they signal that, hey, stay away from me or I'll ink you. And they will. It's not a good thing. This one is the one that we wanted to really stand out, remember? Our little friend over here. This tentacle. There we go. Water. This stuff is pretty thick, this paint. It's got a lot of consistency to it. Maybe I'll throw some right up here at the very tippy top. Like this. See? Boom. There you go. See, now he stands out more. He's got more color, which is what I wanted to do. And now you're like, what? You can't put red on that. What are you doing? Don't put red on the background. Oh, I just did it. It balances out. Don't worry. You've got so much dark in there that it kind of balances out with the... Not a lot, just a little. Just where like the light barely hits it. See? So then it balances more so it's not like, whoop! And nothing back there. I think I'm done. I think I'm done. I'm going to take this and mix some of this weird color with it, and where am I going to sign it? I'm going to paint it all over. Maybe I'll just do it down here. I'm going to use a lighter color. I know, it fell down. Don't freak out. Go with a pink. Pinky, weird color here. Barely have room. Well, sometimes that happens. There we go. You know, the signature's not so important anyway. Just so I know it's mine. like I didn't recognize it anyway. Okay. So, there we go. I'm still working on this part. As the paint dries, it changes colors. So, hopefully you have learned a little bit on how to paint an octopus, how to play with colors, and now, if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, that would be a good time to do so. Yeah, see, I don't want my signature to just, like, stand out that much. I want you to see him like that. Subscribe. That way when I put new ones on there, you'll get a notification right away. You can also go to my Facebook page. If you paint this and I want to see your version of it, then you can paint it and then post it on my Facebook page. And that's Sue Bonnar Artist, and that's B-O-N-N-A-R, not E-R. If you do E-R, you'll be looking for days. Again, I just decided to do that. After you sign it doesn't mean it's done and you can't touch it, but just don't get carried away. So, voila. It's our happy little octopus. And you could do more with him if you want, you could do less with him if you want, but there he is.